Hi everyone, my name is Sirigowri Kambalimath and I study in NIFT Bangalore. I'm here to share my experience and possibly give you some tips and tricks to help you clear NIFT this year. So let's start with the first round you're going to be writing, which consists of your CAT and your GAT. So I'll start with explaining how you can perform in your GAT better. GAT, as you know, has mainly four sections, which is your general knowledge, your aptitude, English comprehension, and math. So what I would recommend is start the paper with a section that you are really comfortable with. So suppose you're more confident and you're better in English comprehension, then start doing the English comprehension first. I recommend doing the GK last because GK comes for 15 marks. And the thing about general knowledge is that you either know it or you don't know it. So I wouldn't advise wasting much time on general knowledge. So keep that towards the last. And I know many people might panic considering the fact that they might not know the answer to a certain general knowledge question. So please don't do that. It's fine. It's completely fine. General knowledge is always, you know, something out of the blue might come. So try attempting that in the last. So start with a section you are really strong at and keep sections such as math and aptitude in the middle, because by the time you start attempting those kind of questions, you'll be in the flow of the exam and you would have calmed down a little bit. And these are the sections that require more thinking and you really need to put your mind to it. So it'll be better if you attempt those questions with a more calm and a steady mind. So yeah, you can either do math or aptitude anyway, but always start with a section you're strong with, and that will actually boost your confidence. So you lose all your worries during the paper. And yeah, do GK in the end. And don't worry if you don't know a question, you can always come back to it. You can just leave the question, but make sure that you mark the next question in the next box. So don't mark question number 7 in question number 6 box. So be really attentive during the exam. And you have 2 hours, it's a good enough time. Don't waste too much time on something you don't know. Attempt everything and then you can come back to it. Leave at least the last 5 minutes to check whether you've attempted everything. Please make sure you've marked it correctly and neatly, and check whether you've answered all the questions, and I'm sure you'll do well. Now coming to the creative ability, now this is a really fun, I personally think it's fun to draw, and the questions are also really interesting. So you shouldn't be very tensed during this part because you need to be really creative, and you're most creative when you're calm. So you can start with reading all 3 questions first. Find a question which you think will take more time and start doing that. And also simultaneously think about how you would draw the other questions. Okay, so that's the thing about the questions. For someone, the question might be tough, but for another person, they might finish the same question in a lesser time. So it's better, it's a more personal thing. So you should find out which questions are easier for you. The thing with CAT I really like is you get 3 hours. So that's a really good time. You get to draw and color and shade and do everything you want to do. So one thing that I have learned personally being in NIFT is that your presentation really matters. And I really want to emphasize on this point about presentation. No matter how bad you think your idea or whatever might be, just present it really well. Make sure you present it well. And you could probably have like a unique way of presenting it instead of just giving a very basic way of drawing it. For example, last year we had a question where you had to design a purse. So the same purse, you can draw it in the way it is, like just the 2D way or probably a slight angle. But what I did, or what I think everyone could try doing, is give different views of the same product. So if you have your drawing space, divide it into 4 spaces and draw the first view, the basic view of the purse, and then probably a side view. And if you think your product or the purse has a really cool or unique handle or a feature that is a feature that should have emphasis, then draw that separately, like draw like a close-up of it, and probably in the side you could have like a color palette or something like that of your product. So that way your idea is viewed in different angles, and you're also putting emphasis on features that might go unnoticed if you just drew it in a very basic way. So and you can even have if not a color palette, you could have a texture palette where you draw the texture that you are using for the product, something like that. It's up to you, but this is just what I've observed. It'll be really cool if you present it that way, because it really catches the eye and it gives a very neat overview of your entire product. And also another thing about CAT is you might be asked to give a small write-up about your design. Don't give a very boring write-up. Don't say that okay, this is my design, blah blah blah, I have used these colors, it does this purpose, it does these things. So make the write-up really fun. You don't have to use very complicated words, just write it in your own style, but make it very fun to read. Think about how you would sell this product to someone else. You have to make the write-up also interesting to read, right? So if it's interesting to read, then it really sticks while you're viewing the product. So make sure the write-up is also really fun. And few points you should mention the write-up is why you've chosen these colors and why you've taken it in this shape, like why it's circular and not in a square and things like that. And if the product has like a function, then the functions of that product. And if you think that there is a very unique feature of the product that might go unnoticed, then please mention it, because sometimes they might not notice it. And always make sure you use good colors. Don't use too many colors. Use like 3-4 colors. Most of the questions will require color unless otherwise stated. But so far, every question has had color. So use colors very wisely. Study about the color theory so you know which colors are used during which situations. And just go ahead with that. Another thing is, if you are unable, or if you think that you are running out of time, then at least give a rough sketch of your idea. Forget about the coloring. Give a rough sketch so at least they'll know what you are thinking of, and they'll give marks for how creative you are, because it's better getting like at least 1 or 2 marks than getting no marks at all, right? So make sure you have a rough sketch for everything. And a lot of people have asked me if you need to make very detailed drawings. Well, I don't think that's necessary unless you really need to. Look at the weightage of marks. If there are a lot of marks, maybe you can go ahead and make a detailed drawing. But if it's just for a few marks, then don't waste too much of time on it. Maybe you can come back to that if you have time in the end. So make sure you have a basic drawing for all 3 questions. And in the end, if you have time, you can come back and do whatever detailing or anything you wanted to do. But just keep it to the point. Don't do anything super extra. Just know how to balance between making it look really good and keeping it minimalistic. But give them what they want. Give them whatever they are asking for first. And then later you can add some things you think might look good for your drawing. But always draw according to what they're asking for. About the materials for CAT, first use any material that you are comfortable with. I personally would recommend color pencils and just brush pens. The thing is, you don't really require a very fancy material, because it's easier to color with color pencils and sketch pens rather than like anything else. What I did was I took watercolor pencils along with those brush pens that have water inside of them, so it's easy to blend. You don't have to, and the effect it gives is something different. But if you are not comfortable with that, then you can go ahead with color pencils or whatever it is, whatever medium you are comfortable with, you can take that. You really don't need to carry everything, like a whole box of materials, that's not required. Take the materials that would help you work faster and won't take up much of your time. You can take sketch pens and brush pens because they dry fast. Just make sure they are the kind of sketch pens that don't leave a mark on the back side of the paper, because otherwise your questions are like one after the other, right? So it shouldn't leave a mark from the previous question, because the next question might be difficult to draw. So just test all your materials once. on like a thick paper. You get like a chart paper kind of material. So just test your materials once so that you don't face any difficulty while drawing. Another tip that I would really personally recommend is staying extremely calm before the exam. Please do not even think about studying for NIFT or do anything related to the entrance one day before. So just go out with your friends, with your family, but do not think about NIFT. Just do not. I'll tell you why. Because for me, I wrote the exam in a very, very calm manner. So I was not stressed about whether I would get in or not. So I just gave it, I just went very casually and I gave my best. So that's what I would like to tell you guys to do, is just be very calm before the exam. You will perform really well if you are calm. Don't even on the day of the exam also, don't call for last minute doubts or don't revise anything. Do not carry any books that are related to NIFT. Please don't, because that'll just make you feel more tensed, and feeling tensed is the last thing you would want, because this time you are starting with CAT and drawing again requires you to be very calm. So I would strongly advise not to do anything related to NIFT at least the night before. Just do everything that takes your mind off of it. Probably go out or just watch a movie or something. And also, an important thing, I might sound like your mom, but please eat breakfast, because NIFT is a 5-hour exam and it is tiring. And not sure where your center might be, but it might be in a locality where you don't get good food outside. So or you can carry snacks and water bottle and all of those things, but please eat a pretty good breakfast, a heavy breakfast. It's really important. And also the reporting time, you don't really have to be exactly on time, so don't start panicking if the reporting time is 8:30 but it's like 8:40 and you aren't there yet. So try to stay as calm as possible. Just switch off your phones, everything. Don't talk to anyone. Just go with a really calm mind and you will do well. Okay. So for those of you who are worried about math, I am really bad at math. I'm telling you honestly, it's not a very strong subject for me, but I can tell you after writing last year's NIFT is that math isn't really that hard. It's just basic 10th standard math. You don't have to worry about it. Please don't get tensed about how the math will go. Just remember your formulas. The formulas are very important, like whatever the area and simple interest, all those formulas. Just remember the formulas. The numbers you get will also be pretty simple. Just don't panic. That's the math is going to be really simple, and I'm telling you, I'm bad at math. So if I found it simple, I'm sure you guys can do it too. But remember the formulas. That's a very important thing. Another tip about reading comprehension, the English comprehension, is I don't think you should waste too much time on it. It's really not hard. It's not like your CBSE or ICSE board papers where you really need to think about it. What I would suggest is the language would be really easy. You won't have super complicated words. I mean, last year we had the spelling of allotment or something like that. So what I would do to save time is I won't even read the passage. Just read the questions and find the same line. Like if you find the answer, then just write that answer or mark that answer. That will save a lot of time. You won't need to read the entire comprehension. If the comprehension is tough, maybe you can consider, you should like read the comprehension. But otherwise, it normally isn't that hard. So just start with reading the questions and your mind will automatically look for the answers in that passage. So that saves a lot of time for you. I would also really like to ask you guys to not think about how your NID paper went or your UCEED paper went or how your pre-boards are going. Don't think about any other exam that's happening right now. Just focus on NIFT. Don't even think about the situation test, because to get to the situation test, you have to clear this, right? So focus more on this, and it'll help you stay more calm. Don't worry about it. This is a completely different paper, and from experience, I'm telling you, NIFT is comparatively easier than NID and UCEED. So I'm sure you would have prepared for those two as well. But since UCEED is just before your NIFT, if that paper doesn't go well, it's okay. It's completely okay. It's a different paper. You have NIFT. It's easy. It's fun. It's a very fun exam. I'll tell you this. So just enjoy it. Don't take any pressure or any stress while writing. Don't think about any other exams. Just think about the exam you are writing right now, which is NIFT, and you'll do well. So the weightage for your first round will be your CAT is 50% of your overall grade. So you get a score after the first round and the second round. So the CAT counts for 50% and the GAT counts for 30%, and your situation test is for 20%. So I think, as it's pretty obvious, focus a little more on your CAT. But don't neglect any other stream. But CAT is important. It's drawing, and try to score the most number of marks. So give your best in CAT and draw neatly, outline, do whatever it is. Follow your individual style. Don't fall to the pressure of what they will want or what they want to see. They really like it if you're being individual and if you have a great design. But CAT is something that you can give a little importance to. But at the same time, don't neglect aptitude, because that's a really easy way to score, since it's not subjective. If you're right, you're right. The thing with drawing is that some people might like it, some people might not like it. So you can focus on your GAT also, because it's easy scoring. I hope you guys found this useful. And remember, just stay calm, enjoy the paper. I'm sure you'll all do well. All the best. I hope you get the score you want.